In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the Rebel Fleet Trooper Troop Builder Pack for the Vintage Collection. I think this was either the second or third Troop Builder Pack that Hasbro did. Previously, I did review the Stormtrooper Pack. I would recommend checking that out, and that one was the very first one. And this one soon followed that. Sometime in 2022, I think it was spring or summer, somewhere in that range. I ended up getting the Stormtrooper Pack and this one really close to the same time. So I've had this for about two and a half years now at this point. It's a really good pack. It is mostly reused parts. We did get a Rebel Fleet Trooper in TVC 1.0. I forget exactly what his number was. I think he may have been in the 50s, somewhere in that range. And here's that action figure right here. There are subtle differences, though, between like these Fleet Troopers and then this one, for instance. I think the plastic quality on the first release was much better than what we ended up getting in the Troop Builder Pack here. At least with the helmet, this feels a lot more gummy and a lot more of a softer plastic. This one feels a little bit more durable. It's still a soft plastic, but it feels like it would hold up a whole lot better than on the Troop Builder Pack ones. That is something I've talked about numerous times before, is I feel like over time, the Star Wars action figures, the plastic quality gets a lot softer and more brittle. Hopefully over time it doesn't deteriorate or anything like that, but so far over the last 2 years it's held up alright. So as I mentioned, I've had this for about two and a half years now at this point. I think I got this set, I'm trying to think. I either got it on eBay or on the Shop Disney site. There were a few packs I ended up getting on the Disney site solely because I could not get it on Hasbro Pulse. It was always sold out, and this was still during that time where pre-orders would go up, and then like 15 minutes later it was already sold out, and it was hit or miss on when it was going to be in stock again, and then it would be back in stock, and then a few minutes later it was already back out. So I thought, I'm not going to mess with it. But for a little while there in 2022... a lot of the Troop Builder sets that the Disney site was getting in was actually pretty reliable. There would be no pre-order at all, and then you could just, it would just go in stock. And then it would be up for at least a couple weeks for most of the sets. I ended up getting the Shore Trooper set through the Disney site as well, and that one was up for quite a while. And I know the Death Trooper set was up for quite some time as well. So what else can I say about this set? So, the marketing director, the previous one, Patrick Schneider, I distinctly recall him mentioning in a live stream revealing this set that there was a lot of diversity in this set. And indeed there is. We ended up getting two white guys here, and they're named characters actually. We have Captain Ramus Antilles here, the same one we see in New Hope that ends up getting choked by Lord Vader. And then we have another named one, which I think a lot of us thought this first Rebel Fleet Trooper was based off of. But this is Lieutenant Paolo Scrambus, I think his name is. Something like that. And he's the Rebel Fleet Trooper that they zoom in on just before the Stormtroopers are breaching through on Tantive IV there. It's a pretty nice action figure. But then we ended up getting an Asian guy and a black guy as well. So it was nice for Patrick to point out the diversity of this set. Overall, I'm happy with it. I never really had Rebel Fleet Troopers until a couple years ago, and now I got several of them. So this was a good way to add some more. I will bring out one more here. This is the one that comes with the Tantive IV hallway set. About a month ago, I did do a setup of the Tantive IV set, so if you haven't seen that up till now, I highly recommend it. And I ended up using just about all of these guys for it. So the first action figure we'll take a look at is Antilles himself. I think this is based upon his appearance in Rogue One, much more compared to what we see in A New Hope. This looks like a much younger version of him. And this was kind of setting the trend of getting named characters in the Troop Builder sets, but fortunately it seems like now Hasbro has indicated that they're probably going to go away from that. Because the whole point of Troop Builder sets is that you can buy like a dozen of them, and they should all be generic characters. But I imagine just having Captain Antilles in the set alone would hold a lot of people back from getting multiples. And you can take his helmet off. It's pretty easy. Unlike the carded Rebel Fleet Troopers, there are no alternative caps. Like this one here, it's just the helmet. It's the head sculpt. It looks all right. We never really see him without a helmet, so I'm not exactly sure what he looks like beyond his face. For the rest of his outfit, it's pretty generic. There's a lot of nice details in his vest here. The pockets, he does have the rank badge there. He does have some pockets on the side of his trousers there. The brown stripe, and brown boots. Think this is pretty much just a repaint of the rest of the Fleet Troopers here. In terms of his articulation, he does have a ball joint in the neck, and then hinged shoulders, elbows, swivel wrists, swivel waist, swivel hips, and then hinged knees, and then hinged ankles. Which I think is perfectly fine articulation for this Fleet Trooper. In terms of accessories, it's pretty standard for all four of them. They all come with the helmet here, which does have a little bit more of a glossy finish on that black visor. This one that come with the Tantive IV set has more of a matte finish. And I think on the original it had a little bit more of a glossy look to it as well. Kind of like an in-between of the matte finish and the glossy one. I think it looks better with it being glossy though. Something interesting as well is on these newer versions, the antenna is just painted silver white, but this one's much darker silver. And for the rest of the accessories, they all come with the standard Rebel Trooper blaster here. Not a whole lot to be said about that, and there are no holsters for any of them to equip them with. I've always liked these Rebel Trooper blaster designs. I think they're pretty cool. So all four of them come with that, but then two of them, I forget exactly which two are equipped with it in the box, but we do get the longer rifle here, which I think this might be the same rifle that comes with the indoor Rebel Commandos. It's a very nice design, looks like something we see in real life. It's a scope, there's a grip here, stock. Unfortunately, the plastic is a little thin on it. As you can see, mine's a little warped. You might be able to work with that a little bit. Well, it's nice that they included something a little bit more besides just four standard Rebel blaster pistols here. Give some more variety. Then for the next three Fleet Troopers, it's all the same. The only difference is the head sculpt here. And yeah, I think that's pretty much the same body as Antilles here. It has the pouches here, which is very nice, just with a black vest instead. and the blue shirt underneath. The pockets on the side of the trousers, gray pants, and then black boots. One notable difference is the three Fleet Troopers do have the ammo that wrap around the leg here, and that is removable. I think the original has a little bit more detail though. There is a hole that's towards the back of his ankle there. You can just plug this in. And it fits on pretty good. And you can see ammo for the original here, much shinier, much more detailed. This one's just more of a matte finish and it's just solid black. It's for the head sculpt. It's pretty good for Lieutenant Pello. Tell the hair is a separately sculpted piece that's attached. Like to try to give a as long of a close look as possible with every figure. Does look like he has a little bit of a smug smirk on him. As if it's like, what, that's all you got? And helmet fits on pretty good. And we have the Asian guy here. And the other two are just generic characters. They don't have any names or show up in any media, as far as I know. Pretty good head sculpt. Kind of looks like someone we've seen in real life, I'm not sure. I'm sure this is based off of a real person, not just someone totally made up. At least I think it would be. That is a pretty good head sculpt. Hair looks good. Face looks good. Same hand positions as well. Basically, a grip pose for blasters. Each hand does have a trigger finger. Then we got the black guy. He's pretty good as well. Have him with the second blaster rifle. And his helmet's a little looser, and that's solely because he's totally bald, so he has less surface area. That is a pretty good head sculpt. Face printing turned out pretty good on all these. But anyways, that's pretty much all I can tell you about the Troop Builder Pack. So for these two here, I'm going to save them for their own individual video at some point. Whenever I do a formal review of the Tantive IV set, I'll feature this guy again. And then I think this original Rebel Fleet Trooper deserves his own video at some point. Personally, between all the Fleet Troopers here, I think this one's my favorite because the quality on it is much better. Unfortunately for my sample, his helmet doesn't fit on too well. The inside where the dome would be is a little large for him, so that's about the best I can do. But other than that, the rest of the paint quality, just the overall plastic or the feel of the plastic, it's much better and more superior, I think. Usually I have them with the cap on, and that fits on pretty good. But despite that, I'm very happy with this set. I think there really isn't any major quality control issues with it. Not like the Stormtrooper set where the paint is sloppy on it or anything looks really off. So would I recommend this set for your collection? I totally would. It's a fantastic release. And of course, if you're a big fan of the Rebels, if you want more Fleet Troopers, this is a great one to add to your collection. I don't think most people are going to want more than one. Like I said, not too many people are probably going to want two of Captain Antilles and then Lieutenant Pello here. For the longest time, Tongori had all four of these individually on his site. But I don't think that's really the case anymore. So if you wanted more of a specific one, that was an option for you for at least a little while. But if you don't have one of these in your collection, totally recommended. Fantastic set. Happy it's a part of my collection. And I'm always happy to add some Rebel Fleet Troopers. But anyways, that concludes this review. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for plenty more reviews in the future. There will always be more to come. If you haven't already, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. I always appreciate all your support. And check out some links in the description if you haven't done so already. Of course, as always, thanks for watching.